Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of SQL Server along with their GUI interface, that is SQL Server Management Studio or SSMS version 21 on Windows operating system. So to install SSMS, first you need to go to your favorite browser. I have to type over here SQL Server download. Hit enter. So that will show you this SQL Server download link from Microsoft.com. So just simply go to their official site. Here if you scroll down, you will see that our SQL Server is available for both developer version and Express edition. So I'm going to download the Express edition. So just simply click on this download button for Express and immediately our exe will get downloaded. So just simply click on this installer. Deluxify administrative privileges, click on yes. And there you go, our installation wizard for SQL Server is rightly open. So just start with the basic installation. So this is our license agreement, you must read this, click on accept. So this is where our Microsoft SQL Server is going to be installed. Totally fine, click on install. Immediately it's going to start installing our SQL Server. So it's going to take some time to install SQL Server. You need to also have active internet connection during this installation. So we'll come back. So now you can clearly see that our SQL Server 22 is rightly installed. So these are all connection string, SQL Server installation log folder, media folder and resources folder. So everything is fine. Now it's time to install SSMS. So just simply click on this install SSMS. So that's going to redirect to your browser by showing this install SQL Server Management Studio. So here you need to scroll down and you can see step one. So to check your system requirement, you can always check it by clicking on the system requirement. So you can always read this. You need to have minimum of Windows 11 or Windows 10 also it's going to support, or if you're using Windows Server. So these are all versions where SSMS is going to be supported. So everything is fine. You can always read this, go through this. You'll be also able to know which are all hardware you'll need. So let's download SSMS. So click on this download SSMS 21 link. So immediately we'll get a setup of Visual Studio SSMS.exe downloaded over here. So that's the new thing they have introduced on this latest version of SSMS 21. So you can see this latest release of SQL Server Management Studio version 21 that is hosted on Microsoft servers. So basically this installation procedure will be pretty much same to installing Visual Studio. So let's start installing SSMS. So click on this installer. So Visual Studio installer will start opening and it's going to ask for administrative privileges. Click on yes. Let's minimize our browser and you can also close this SQL Server. Yes, close it and Visual Studio installer rightly open. Click on continue. So it's going to download some of the packages and there you go. So let's first maximize it. So we are going to install SQL Server Management Studio 21. So here are all different checkboxes. I always recommend you to install all these options. So starting with Copilot, Business Intelligence, Hybrid and Migration along with Code Tools. So total space required will be 2.7 GB. So that much amount of bandwidth you must have. And you can always switch to this individual component and language pack and installation location if you want to change anything. So you can always check out all these different things. I'm going to start installing SSMS 21. So when you click on that, it's going to show you starting downloading option. So our SQL Server Management Studio 21 is rightly started downloading and installing. So this entire process will take some time, about 3 to 4 minutes. It totally depends upon your internet speed as well. So we'll come back. So you can see that our SQL Server Management Studio version 21 installing is rightly done. So installation has completed. We recommend you to restart your Windows to clean it up. So I also recommend you to do the same. Please restart your system and then again you can come back to this video. For now I'm going to just simply click on OK. And to start launch our SQL Server Management Studio, you can always click on this launch button from this Visual Studio installer. Or else, first I am going to close this, you can just simply go to search and just simply type SSMS. So that will show this SQL Server Management Studio under this app. Or you can also go to apps. And there also you will get this newly created software. So if you want, you can always right click and pin this to start, or you can also get the entire file location. So that is this shortcut. So you can just copy it and you can just simply paste it, place it over desktop. So with that also you'll be easily able to open SQL Server Management Studio. Just double click on it. So that's going to immediately start launching our SQL Server Management Studio version 21. So here first it will tell you to sign in to SQL Server Management Studio. So I always recommend you to sign in. You can sign in using GitHub or a Microsoft account as well. For now I'm going to skip this. This is only because I don't want to make this video that much long. And there you go. So first it will show you this pop-up. So we are excited to introduce a new connection dialog experience. So that's why these two options. You can always use the latest features. So I'll always recommend you to click on yes. So that's going to only open their new interface. So here is our latest connection window. So you need to provide server name over here. To know what is your system name or server name, you can always go to search and just simply type system info. So that will under app show you the system information. So open that and you will get the system name over here. So my system name is GS. You should be getting your own system name. So you need to get that system name and you need to type your system name over here. So I'm going to type my system name and then I'm going to give a slash and going to type SQL Express. So that is our server name. So you need to type your own system name over here and then you need to give SQL Express. And we are going to proceed with Windows authentication in this video. In my next video, I'm going to elaborately talk about this SQL Server authentication. So for that, you need to subscribe our channel and press the bell button to get notified. So that's going to be my next video. And here you need to select this Trust Server Certificate and keep all other things at default and click on connect. And there you go. So you can see that we are now connected to SQL Express. So if you expand this database, you will get system database and database snapshots. And if you expand the system database, you will get all the system databases that come along with our SQL Server. So let's write some SQL code. So click on this new query. And that will open this new query window. Just to save time, I have already prepared a sample SQL code. So I'm going to copy it and I'm going to just simply paste it over here. And this entire code you will get on our article. So that article link also will get on our channel description. So first to start with, we need to create a database first. So let's first create database and give the database name as employee. End with semicolon and just simply select this and click on execute. So you can see that our command is rightly executed. So you can increase this size to something around 200. So now you have better visibility, I guess. So now let's create a table, select this, click on execute. So command executed successfully. Let's insert a couple of values one by one. So one refactored is inserted, also insert another value, again inserted. Now fetch all the stuff from our table. So select start from EMP, click on execute and there you go. You can see that our EMP table is rightly fetched over here with ID 1 for Saurabh and ID 2 for Rahul. Right. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of SSMS, that is SSMS version 21 on a Windows operating system. In my next video, I'm going to talk about SQL Server authentication. So do watch that video as well if you're interested on SQL Server authentication. And if you're interested on Python, then I always recommend you to watch this playlist. I am sure you're going to love this. So all this project along with detailed source code, you are going to get on our official website, geekyscript.com. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.